Hello all, I'm Anagashvi. The topic for today's presentation is continuous distribution. First, we will see what is continuous distribution. So, a continuous distribution describes the probabilities of the possible values of a continuous random variable. So, what is continuous random variable? A continuous random variable is the one which has the range of values that is infinite and uncountable. The probabilities of these continuous random variable, say x, is given by the area under the curve of its PDF, that is probability distribution function. There are 9 different continuous distributions. So some of them we have already studied in module 2. Now today we'll see more on gamma distribution and Erlang distribution. First, we will see gamma distribution. So, coming to gamma distribution, here there are 2 different parameters, namely beta and theta. Beta is the shape parameter, whereas theta is the scale parameter. When a random variable x is gamma distributed with parameters beta and theta, if its PDF is given by f of x, small f of x. So the small f of x goes as follows. If x is greater than 0, it is beta theta over gamma of beta into beta theta x to the power beta minus 1 into e power minus beta theta x. Otherwise, the value of f of x is 0. Coming to this gamma function here is given as follows. Now let us see what is CDF, that is continuous distribution function of gamma distribution, which is given by capital F of x. If x is greater than 0, then capital F of x is equal to 1 minus integral x to infinite beta theta of gamma beta theta t to the power beta minus 1 into e power minus beta theta t dt. If x value is less than or equal to 0, then capital F of x is equal to 0. Now we will see the mean of gamma distribution. So mean, which is nothing but E of x, is given by 1 over theta, whereas variance, capital V of x, is given by 1 over beta theta square. Now we will see a problem on gamma distribution in order to understand it better. So the problem statement goes as follows. The time required to repair a CPU is gamma distributed, with mean and variance as 1. We should find the probability that the next non-working CPU arriving will be repaired in less than an hour. Now we'll solve this problem. So in the given problem statement, it is clear that it is gamma distributed and mean and variance is equal to 1. So we know mean is equal to 1 over theta. So 1 over theta is equal to 1. And variance V of x is equal to 1 over beta theta square, which is also equal to 1. So with these two equations, we can arrive at theta and beta, which is equal to 1. And what we should find? We should basically find the probability that the next non-working CPU will be repaired in less than an hour. So we should find the probability that x should be less than 1. So we should find probability of x less than or equal to 1. As we know, the formula goes like this, and we shall apply the same formula over here. So now let us substitute the value of x, which is equal to 1, in this particular formula, and within the integral remains the same. Further, we will also substitute what is beta and theta value, which is 1, over here in this equation. Now it becomes 1 minus integral 1 to infinity beta into theta, that is 1 into 1. The value of beta and theta, we arrived it as 1. So it is 1 over gamma of beta. The value of beta here is 1. So gamma of 1 is always equal to 1. So it is gamma of beta here is 1. Next, beta theta t, that is 1 into 1 into t, which is nothing but t to the power of beta minus 1. Beta value is 1, so 1 minus 1. Into e power minus beta theta t, that is e power minus 1 into 1 into t, that is minus t dt. Now we'll further simplify this equation. So it comes out to be 1 minus integral 1 to infinity, 1 by 1 goes off, and we have t to the power 1 minus 1 0 into e power minus t dt. Next, t power 0 is 1, so we can ignore that. And finally, within the integration, we remain with only e power minus t dt. So this is very simple integration, and the integration goes as follows. So 1 minus remains the same, followed by integral of e power minus t dt is e power minus t divided by minus 1. So which is from 1 to infinity. Now we'll substitute infinity and 1 over here. So when we substitute infinity, we get 0. And when we substitute 1 for t, we get minus e power minus 1. So upon solving this equation, we arrive at the value 0.632. So finally, we can conclude that the probability that the next non-working CPU arriving will be repaired in less than an hour, which is so this probability is 0.632. Now we'll see what is Erlang distribution. As previously said, we have something called as beta parameter in gamma distribution. So when beta becomes equal to an integer k, then we call it as Erlang distribution. So Erlang distribution is also a form of gamma distribution. Coming to the probability distribution function, PDF of Erlang distribution, which is given by small f of x, is equal to beta theta over gamma beta, gamma of beta, into beta theta x to the power beta minus 1 into e power minus beta theta x. So here the value of beta is equal to k. This is Erlang distribution. So beta value is equal to k. And this formula of f of x is also same as the one of, as that one of gamma distribution. Now we'll see CDF, that is continuous distribution function of Erlang distribution, given by capital F of x, which is equal to, like, if x is greater than 0, capital F of x becomes 1 minus summation of I is equal to 0 to k minus 1 e power minus k theta x into k theta x to the power I over I factorial. If the value of x is less than or equal to 0, then capital F of x is equal to 0. The mean, that is capital E of x of Erlang distribution, is given by 1 over k theta, and variance of Erlang distribution is given by 1 over k theta square. We'll see a simple problem with respect to Erlang distribution, and the problem statement goes as follows. The time interval between dial-up connection and ISP is exponentially distributed with mean of 15 seconds. We should find the probability that the third dial-up connection occurs after 30 seconds has elapsed. So here in the problem statement, they have given it as exponential distribution, but we are solving the problem of Erlang distribution. So in the question, they won't explicitly mention it as Erlang distribution. It will be given as exponential distribution, and with the given data in the question, we should conclude whether it's Erlang distribution or exponential distribution. And they have also given the mean as 15 seconds. So mean E of capital E of x is equal to 1 over k theta, which is equal to 15. From this, we get k theta as 1 over 15. And we should find the probability that third dial-up connection, so k value is 3, occurs after 30 seconds. So x value is 30. We should find the probability occurrence after 30 seconds. So the final probability which we find will be P of x greater than 30, which is equal to 1 minus P of x less than or equal to 30. The equation or the formula which we should substitute over here is this one, which is 1 minus summation of I is equal to 0 to k minus 1 e power minus k theta x into k theta x to the power I over I factorial. So if we substitute it here, we have already 1 here and this one. If we substitute here, this 1 and here 1 gets cancelled. So we'll be only remaining with this summation part. And if we substitute the value of k, that is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. So I is from 0 to 2, followed by e power minus k theta x. So e power minus k theta value is 1 over 15. So 1 over 15 into x value is 30. 30. So similarly, we'll substitute k theta x, that is 1 by 15 into 30 here to the power I divided by I factorial. Let us now simplify this equation further. So 1 over 15 into 30 is nothing but 30 by 15, that is 2. So we get e power minus 2, 2 power I divided by I factorial. Now we'll substitute the value of I is equal to 0, 1 and 2 and find the sum of that. When we substitute 0, 1 and 2, it comes out to be like this, the summation term. Now we'll further simplify each of these terms. So when we simplify all these terms and add it up together, we get the final answer as 0.677. And this is nothing but probability of x greater than 30. Hence, we can conclude that the probability that third dial-up connection occurs after 30 seconds has lapsed is 0.677. So this is about Erlang distribution. Thank you.